major crime bill. Every minor crime bill has had the name of the Democratic senator from the state of Delaware, Joe Biden, on that bill.
We do everything but hang people for jaywalking in this bill.
I mean, you got the first sort of mainstream African American who was articulate and bright and clean and nice looking guy. I mean, it's, that's a story, man.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent. It's a point.
Spent last summer going through the black sections of my town, holding rallies in parks, trying to get black men to understand it's not unmanly to wear a condom, getting women to understand they can say no, getting people in the position where testing matters. I got tested for AIDS. I know Barack got tested for AIDS. There's no shame in being tested for AIDS.
Romney wants to let he said the first 100 days, he's going to let the big banks once again write their own rules. Unchain Walton. They're going to put you all back in chains.
The most foreign policy experts around the world say is the most wisest man in the Orient.
Large, very identifiable Somali community. I might add, if you ever come to the train station with me, you'll notice that I have great relations with them because there's an awful lot of driving cabs.
We have this notion that somehow if you're poor, you cannot do it. Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
What responsibility do you think that Americans need to take to repair the legacy of slavery in our country?
We bring social workers into homes of parents to help them deal with how to raise their children. It's not that they don't want to help. They don't know quite what to do.
I recognize that kid wearing a hoodie may very well be the next poet laureate and not a gangbanger.
You got more questions, but I tell you, if you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
And by the way, what you all know, but most people don't know, unlike the African-American community, with notable exceptions, the Latino community is an incredibly diverse community with incredibly different attitudes about different things.
Have you taken a cognitive...
No, I haven't taken a test. Why the hell would I take a test? Come on, man. That's like saying you, before you got in this program, you take a test whether you're taking cocaine or not. What do you think, huh?
Hunter?
Are you a Jody?
Listen, Jody, the reason I was able to stay...
That's enough. The short video. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen and ladies, welcome back, family. Short little video. And our bill tonight, or today, or this morning, this weekend, or during the week, it's properly titled, The Race. It's still on. The race is still on. It's still on. I talk about race today because
Young black entrepreneurs are just as capable of succeeding given the chance as white entrepreneurs are. But they don't have lawyers. They don't have accountants. But they have great ideas.
This is your press.
We should challenge students in these schools.
This is the one that the people forgot who he is, what he is. And I'll be goddamn. We're going to vote 4 more years with Trump back in the office. It's time for him to go.
How many times you get to call? I'd like to talk to you about your credit card.
You were running in Democratic primaries against Southerners like
time for him to go.
And John Edwards.
Better than anybody else. You don't know my state. My state was a slave state. My state is a border state. My state is the 8th largest black population in the country. My state is anything from a northeast liberal state.
So
when Detroit found out they didn't have when all the exodus, they didn't have
enough this time.
We already have a nigger mayor. We don't need.
He knows better.
A ninja mayor.
I think the two-party system.
Quite well, Sam.
Like
but It's all over, man. It's all over.
What he used to do is go down.
It's
the notion that somehow if you're poor, you cannot do it. Poor kids are just as brave and just as
talented. Who are the poor kids?
Wealthy kids. Black kids.
White kids. Wealthy.
But think about it. We think, no, we're going to dumb it down. They can do anything anybody else can do, give it a shot.
Yeah.
He knows better.
Listen. You the people. We're the people. We have a big decision on this next race. Okay? This next race that's coming up in 2024. It's going to be huge. It's going to be very huge. And I'll be goddamn, again, I say, we vote him back in office. Time for him and her to go. To go. Black people forgot. They forgot. I had a little bit of amnesia. Or who this chump is. He always been racist. He's the one who wrote the crime bill back in 1994 for Clinton. He was co-author of the crime bill. The crime bill that exploded America's criminal justice system. But you forgot. You forgot who this sucker is. He's not for us. Okay? So, yes, he's racist. And this next race is going to be very important. Must I add again? So, there's always been a race problem here in America. It has never really stopped. It has never really died down. It's always been a race problem. And I try to avoid talking about race so much on our bill on this channel, The Fly Optician, Inspirational Minutes with David. But it is what it is. This next race will be very important. I'm going to read a few things. I've been reading this book called Stay Woke. And it talks about how some of this stuff started. We know through slavery. We know through Jim Crow. We know through the black laws. We know segregation has continued and continued. It's been here for a long time. So, respectfully, President Nixon and President Nixon and President Reagan. This is two quotes from political operatives of President Nixon and President Reagan. Quote unquote. You understand what I'm saying? We knew we couldn't make it illegal to be either against the war or black. But by getting the public to associate the hippies with marijuana and blacks with heroin and then criminalizing both heavily, we could disrupt those communities. We could arrest their leaders, raid their homes, break up their meetings, and vilify them night after night after night on the evening news. Did we know that we were lying about the drugs? Of course we did. Quote a John H. Lynchman, White House counsel and assistant to the president for domestic affairs under President Nixon, 1968. You start out in 1954 by saying the N-word, G-G-E-R, the N-word, G-G-E-R, and the N-word, G-G-E-R. You know what the hell I'm talking about. By 1968, You can't say it, the N-word. And that hurts you. Backfires. So you say stuff like forced busing states, rights, and all that stuff. And you're getting so abstract. Now you're talking about cutting taxes. And all these things you're talking about are totally economic things. And a byproduct of them is blacks get hurt worse than whites. We want to cut this. It's much more abstract than even the busing thing. And a hell of a lot more abstraction than the SEC N-word. N-word. That's Lee Atwater, aide to President Ronald Reagan, 1981. These quotes provide a glimpse into the intentions of political operatives who work in the White House to deceptively associate blacks with drugs and crime. These quotes provide insight into how certain words or phrases have been used to reach white voters in the South without saying the word black. In other words, they serve as dog whistles. You know, a dog whistle, you can't really hear it. But people who know, they know. To promote policies detrimental to African Americans or black people. It's important to note that John Etheridge's quote above the dates from 1968, incarceration rates began to increase in 1970. Between 1970 and 2000, incarceration rate in the United States expanded by 400%, a higher rate for any other country in the free world. You see, this was something that we put a blind eye to, you know. You have people like J. Edgar Hoover, the notorious FBI director, stated in 1965, I'm greatly concerned that certain radical leaders are suggesting that citizens need only obey the laws with which they agree. Quote unquote. He was a racist. The FBI began a co-intelligence program called COINTELPRO to undermine the civil rights movement. There are a lot of people on the list. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, what they call it, SNCC. A. Philip Randolph, a civil rights activist. Adam Clayton Powell Jr., the Black Panther Party, Elijah Muhammad, the leader of the Nation of Islam, and the NAACP. It was bad. It was bad back then, but what made it tolerable for people was that you know who they were, okay? And for us to vote that guy back into the office. He was a vice president, they voted him to president into the office. Who wrote a crime bill, especially against crack cocaine. You know, that crack cocaine, you get caught with 5 grams of crack cocaine. A crack cocaine, you get life sentence. You get caught with 5 grams of white powder cocaine, you get probation. Hunter, see, the universe has a way of putting out jokes, but the truth is always in the joke. The truth is always in the joke. So, the next race is very important. It's very, very important. And it's time to get a new administration in office. It's time. I'm not saying that racism is going to go away. I'm not saying that you're going to have some low-minded people. I'm just saying that we need a new administration on the next race of the races. Damn. They screw the news. Damn. They make the news be scripted to say what it wants to say or they want it to say. Again, the person that was put into the office on this administration, it's time to go. With your racist ass, it's time to go. And when you learn and realize, you become awakened. It's not about BLM or Black Lives Matter. It's fake. Race, religion, politics, personality, etc., etc. This is what is used to control the sheep, the sheeple, the herd. It's been used throughout his story. And it starts with problem, reaction, solution, narrative. Again, it starts with the problem, reaction, solution, narrative. Then optics of mass acceptance of the same. Then public shaming. Then public disruptions. Then violence. And it will get worse. It's going to get worse. Until or unless it will get worse. It will get worse until and unless we choose. We choose to unite together as one people. When you realize that the controllers, the 1%, the controllers, have other people controlling to get their agenda through. People will be exploited and used. That's how it works. But we choose, we all choose to come together on love, living on value energy together as a human race. Don't take the bait. Stop taking the bait. Don't get triggered. Be conscious. Be cognizant. Be aware that they are trying to divide us all as sheep to be called. Cult. C-U-L-L-E-D. Cult. It's not rebellion or conspiracy to have a heart and be willing to go where others refuse to go. To go where others refuse to go. It's standing for truth, devotion to love and wisdom. It's the guiding principle in these times. Now we can choose to commit ourselves to love, truth, light, unity, and goodness to enable positive transformation instead of fake expectations appearing real fear. And together, our collective creative force will determine, it will determine our reality. If only we allow the truth to come and be embedded within us, to come together as a people. Now, if we allow some person, group, ideology, narrative, agenda to control us or keep controlling us, will rob of our capacity. Our capacity to unite and embody our true physical, emotional, and spiritual power. We are all connected. 2024. The race is on. The race is on. Do the right thing. It's coming. Question everything. Stop being so gullible. Research everyone. Research everything. Then make your decision. If you made it this far, and that inspiration. Minutes with David, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notifications, and let you know that our channel is back on, okay? Get the book. I didn't talk about the book. Get the book, The Audacity Awoke, A Memoir of a Man Who Has Been Mentally Asleep. Kindle soft cover, hardcover, audio. There's no reason not to have the book. The race is on. Make the right decision. I'm leaving you in peace. Positive energy. Always create evolution. If I love me, then I love you. And if you love you, you love me in return. I love you in truth. I love you in truth. We have a race of the races, of the race. It's gonna be huge. It's gonna be epic. You have the power. Until next time, peace.